Speak Student.
Graphing and visualizing limits a la shmup. Big Randy used to be a sumo wrestler in the 80s, so he decides to write a guide on how to get that sumo body for the youngsters who want to be the next generation's Big Randy. His secret was eating donuts by the box, but he's forgotten how many boxes he needs to eat to get to a certain weight. He decides to relive his glory days and find an equation that models his weight gain. He decides to set X as the number of donut boxes he eats and Y as the number of pounds gained. He decides that if he's going to try to help out every aspiring sumo wrestler, he's going to need a lot of data. So he sells his 24-karat gold two-piece wrestling suit that he won in the World Championships of 85 and buys 1,000 boxes of donuts and graphs his weight gain after each box. He makes it through the whole batch and checks his results. Looks like he forgot to record his weight after 200 boxes and 600 boxes. Instead of doing his experiment all over again and buying another 1,000 donut boxes, he decides to use something called limits to estimate his weight gain at those missing points. Here's what Big Randy's graph currently looks like. Notice the missing points called holes at x equals 200 and the jump at x equals 600. Let's start by figuring out the hole at x equals 200. His weight gain at 200 can be estimated by the y value that corresponds to the graph when x is really, really close to 200, which is called a limit. At x equals 199, his weight gain was 49.8 pounds. At x equals 201, his weight gain was 50.2 pounds. It looks like the limit as x approaches 200 boxes of donuts is about 50 pounds. Note that we did this even though the graph is discontinuous and technically didn't have a value at that point. We just guessed. We can try to find the limit of a function at any x value. But here Big Randy only cares about the limit of the graph at x equals 200 and 600 boxes. Now let's look at the jump at 600 boxes. A limit requires that the y values are the same going from x values greater than or less than the x value in question, in this case, 600. At 599.99 boxes, his weight gain was 98.9 pounds, and at 600.01 boxes, his weight gain was 110 pounds. It might look like the weight gained at 600 boxes could be 102, 105, or even 108 pounds. But the problem is that there is such a small space between 599.99 and 600.01 that there's only one space for a single value. In other words, the values at 599.99 and 600.01 boxes need to be almost the same, like at 200, for the limit to exist. So, at 600, the limit does not exist. Well, what does that mean? It means that something wacky must have happened at box 600. It's all coming back to him now. He forgot to record the gallon of milk he drank with his 600th box of donuts. Sorry, Randy,